Welcome back. We have now decided to close the building at the area of the place. We need to go to other parts to have some international economic transfers. It's very troubling for the region. Okay? Norway decides to link to the common country area. We call it the Euro. What is the fact? It's saving us our money from the public. Number one, because the public experience in saving our money. So the production that we need. So you lose something if you go to the first place. So it's not like a win-win. But what we discussed is simply this. What happens to the Norwegian economy if we go into it? Yes, saving. Transfer, saving money for the person. But what happens if this lead needs to be bought from a Norwegian state? Then we need a state that's correct. And it's state enough. What happens to prices if the economic situation is unstable? Our problem. 25 years ago, when they decided to enter the euro site, prices went up and down. What happened to the up and down for the conditions? So the problem is that we're not able to decide what wants to be important. Prices vary. Same green wages. What happens is there is what they expect in this economy, which means less demand. This means that debt to funding of getting a new in some industries, if this economy is growing, they want to be compensated. So wages going up and down is instable economic situation. Okay? So to gain monetary stability, we lose the change. Is this a problem for the Eurozone? We probably ask you to send an email to Athens, Dublin, Lisbon, and a few other countries that are in need. Do they feel that this fixed exchange rate system is very good for the economy? But they're using products that are very good for the market as well. So, what's the point of stability in a monetary policy? Yes, the money for the economy. So, the problem is it is a balance. It is imbalance. Yes, it is. Okay? Things can move within the system. So if there are less demand for Norwegian goods, Norwegian can apply for their consumer Denmark, Germany, UK, Italy, or other countries. It works also the other way. If the Norwegian economy is strong, that's the apply for work. Because you have more available Norwegian goods. Somebody asked your partner, where is he working now? The partner said, I nothing that you should come up. You can move within this realm of becoming to come up and find new ways to get better training or better enough and better qualities. Use your intention. So that is the heart of having one super heart. You can move within the system that you have to do. But the problem is, no one wants to go through the grief. Because that's not what it is. So that is the kind of instability in real life. So, there are effects between all the kinds when you have those effects. One should know the state in that process. What is this question? There are no other areas that is so important. More than 70% of the UK trade in the living room. They should be broken. They should leave the area that we trade to go into a different area than we do not trade. But simply, we are so close to that, we're so close to the limit. What we produce is leading within the EU. What the EU produce leads when we can deliver. We may listen to that. And if there are, say, problems, workers can get both concentration effects. And this is the other case we have to read in chapter 10. The high degree of economic integration between countries and countries may allow the growth to reduce the economic instability because the market is stable. More. And what gives us the opposite answer? Is that the disturbances in the EU market are Spain, Italy, Greece, Portugal, and Portugal. So, probably in this period, it would have been better to have made it. Okay, then we have 5 minutes to use the stone and the technique. We are ready for the stone for 5 minutes. Administration that says I have a custom version. If you look at me, do we need that now? If you have past history, I'd like to show you that this is my past history. This is our contemporary to our class before election. It's called Rainbow of the Night Program. It's signed by one Pablo Fonte. If you send it, I can achieve show you the practice, but you would be very amazed. Because when he did this, he was the most productive whole life. And this is the highly regulated, most highly regulated. It's even more there from that wonder from. But here it is. There is an imperfection between the two markets. One that is very the
Italy, Mongolia, France, Mongolia,
all their parents know this are numbers. People can be a bit spread out to them because they are information in the area, because all the numbers are numbers in the end. I don't know if you are not here because it's just what the Muslims are agreeing with. The Prophet said, we don't come to many Europeans coming into our country. That is a different story. If you ask Buddhists in Switzerland, if they should have a fixed or a floating rate with Europe, I think they should be doing whatever else you can do. You won't fix it. Right. Because the most of my point is that I know that I'm not having to do this. So there are so-called integrated, implicitly. If they want to play parents the outside early, how far do they have to go? Where is Hitler? Where are the nearest non-Indian member? Denmark or Iceland? How many Icelanders holding partners do you think there are in Switzerland? What do they mean? They can get a fix from everywhere, you must buy them from Iceland. How many holding partners do Switzerland have in Turkey? Not too many. So, yes, they are integrated, the potential is clear. Very good. So, if you get this question for our return, the answer is very short. Well, but if you don't believe it, you must have to think once more. What is the conclusion of the text? In chapter 28, there are trading areas in Asia, in the US, and in Europe. Are they closely integrated? No. South of the US is a trading area. East of Europe is a trading area. Russia and Brazil. One is closer integrated than the other. The closest integrated of the outside trade area is in fact Russia. But I think there is a trading rate between Europe and Russia and Europe. All the other areas are so far away that there are no integrations. So the answer is, do not join in a fixed trade system. Okay? It is very little to go for. Okay, can we come to the conclusion? And there's still 7 minutes to go. If you an excellent currency area. And just look around you and think. I think the answer is no, yes. We don't have no, but we say nothing. Simply because we don't know the future. But I think you have to be an optimist. And being a political Madrid supporter. I'm hoping for the same time. But I think very simply, in my opinion. But what happens to the future of EMU, the monetary union? At the moment, it's very complicated. Liberty is trying to stay open. I think the answer is it could have been better for the future. If EMU was to simple answer. Sweden, Edward, yes. Corona, Denmark, we have the bear corona. UK and Germany, forget the plan and hope for the best. So, yes, I think the future is not yet decided. But if you ask somebody from central London if they want to join in the Europe, just by going to football game in New York. And if there are no armed policemen in the room, they are going to be second. So I think they are not yet. But what flexible, European way if you use right. Never mind the technology itself. If you are from Germany and want to go in Sweden, where is that? Maybe. Very easy. It's not a thing with the population. Two, if you need to reform the fiscal system, which means the public tax and spending system. We have had a discussion during the break, which is clear in this part, to begin. Obviously, there are different approaches to this, but not strong support so far as the chapter to the fiscal system of Germany, which is the cornerstone of the EU. So, I'm happy with the German system. We cannot be happy with the EU system. We need closer political relations. It has to be a federal state. So there is somebody up there deciding, and we want down there and stop. And first, we need one central bank. It's not in a moment. It's the central bank. If it's one system, there is one central bank. We have 18. It doesn't sound like one thing. So yes, there is a way to go before this. Is it wrong to establish the euro system in 1999? I conclude my answer is no. We don't know. I'm not sure. But so far, it is not a unified system. Okay, you are younger than me, so you might experience that it is better. But I'm afraid, before I get my eyes tired, it's still not intact. Should that be a bet? You need just to pay for the transport into the hospital that now he is taken away by his partner. Now it's no big discussion. What is there to be nothing? But one of the first year that we also have a so, the conclusion is very easy to come up with. It's a nice system to have. If it works, it's a very nice system to have. As long as I am, let's say, partly sane and not safe in the hospital, you can come back and discuss it every year if you want to. But I'm afraid the answer is not the coming year or the coming 5 years. So we will have to do that at the 10 years anniversary. And then we need to do that. So let's say on the 4th of April 2024, we come back here and discuss the leaders. And if you pay as much as the town there, I will pay all your expenses in town. The first level. And then we will go fishing, and I share the best Norwegian fish at the university. If you don't like fish, I can have an appointment when you have salad or fish. See you in 2024, where we discuss the university once again. I think it's pretty much the same. Have a nice weekend.